What's up, everybody? Vinny Dayon here with the new tales from the Borderlands, baby. Yo, I'm a big Borderlands fan, man. I didn't play it at the beginning because I don't know, it wasn't my kind of game. The cartoon looking, you know, I was. And then my buddy was like, "Bro, it's a badass game. Come on, man, try it with me. Try me." So he forced me to try it, and then I started liking the looting and the upgrading and all that stuff. I just had to deal with the graphics for it because of part one, you know. But it ended up being a great game. I ended up bawling out on that thing for years. And then the two came out and I was on that for years, bro. What? Yo, Borderlands is amazing. So yeah, I had to get this. I was like, bro, it's on sale. I gotta get it, man. I gotta get it. So yeah, now I'm getting the new. So let's get into it, bro. I'm waiting to play this thing. You ready? Let's go.
Think you've seen it all, huh? Think you know all there is to know about Vault Hunters, bandits, corporations, and nobody loser types? Well, you don't know skagdiddly. Take Promethea, for example. A civilized place, as far as planetary-sized piles of excrement go. A planet still recovering from its war with the Malewan Corporation. The rival Atlas Corporation is in bad shape. Reese Strongfork, the big shot CEO with the regrettable mustache, is scrambling. He's on the cusp of something big. But he's not the only one. And into this pressure cooker steps Dr. Anuradha Dhar, genius inventor, socially awkward, do-gooder type. She works for Atlas, been tinkering with a big, award-winning idea. Her brother, Octavio Wallace Dhar, Meridian City's most well-known man, at least in his own mind, he's convinced his big break is just around the corner. And Fran Miskowitz, purveyor of Reese Strongfork's favorite Froger flavor. She's hoping for a big insurance payout after that regrettable Malawan laser incident. So, you're probably asking yourself, what makes these three so special? And the answer is nothing. Yet.
You're free now. Go! Be free. Run.
Oh, no,
run.
Not again.
Morning.
What? Oh, I mean, good morning.
Seriously. Again?
Yep. Another busy day. Work, work, work. Am I right?
Thank you.
By channeling the Iridium's energy through a multiphasic refraction lens, I can reproduce the, as yet, inexplicable powers of the Sirens. Maybe not the wings thing, which is so cool, but crucially, the ability to manipulate an object safely through space-time.
I'm Anu, the ultimate Siren fangirl, but for totally scientific reasons, I swear, and I'm so close to replicating the signature move of my all-time favorite Siren, Lilith. R.I.P.
Pong.
Anu.
As I was saying, in addition to forever altering the nature of conflict, vis-a-vis offering a non-lethal resolution, my device could also change the world. For the better. Imagine, a way for people to solve their problems without killing each other.
I literally can't.
I just have to figure out how to actually bring back the objects I phased away. And also, where they go. And also, what happens to them. Simple. Interdepartmental demonstration scheduled for 2 weeks from today. Dr. Anuradha Dar, signing off.
Oh, snap. 2 weeks? Really? It's going to be ready by then? You always seem so hesitant to put a timeline on this bad boy, so, you know, 2 weeks. Wow.
Yeah, I'm sort of hoping setting the goal will force me to meet the goal, you know?
Oh, yeah, that's definitely how that works, so.
All I've got to do is just figure out the next step. That's it. There's got to be something I'm missing.
Figure it out with, like, your intuition or with your tech goggles?
I would like to think both.
Maybe start with the tech goggles, though. There's a button on the side.
Okay, goggles. Let's try a diagnostic. So, for starters, I should probably put an actual power source in there, huh?
You needed the goggles for that.
Now, where did I put that iridium ore?
I remember you securing it a while ago.
I don't know why I ever thought a Jabberman translator was a good idea. It worked, sure, but it turns out all they want to do is fornicate and fling feces. What a waste of time. Would a clearer-headed Anu have stored the iridium in here before calling it a night? And would a clearer-headed Anu remember the code to her safe for once?
Mm-hmm.
hiding the key component to your...
Better grab some money for lunch while I've got this bad boy unlocked.
Did you say lunch? You buying?
Now that I look at the Jabberman translator with fresh eyes, I realize I may have made a miscalculation in the translation matrix. For all I know, they could have been spouting philosophy.
Now, if it were me, I'd have it on my desk. Were you seriously about to scan me without my consent? Not cool. We really need to work on your people skills, boss. If you want to know what's in my pocket, ask.
Fong, can you tell me what's in your pocket?
It's a Vaultlander figure. Some of the other lab assistants and I like to play before work. I totally creamed Roberts this morning, and this was my sweet reward.
My trusty tools. So much potential for science in these simple implements. And what's that? Oh, Anu, really? Got you.
Left the rare and incredibly expensive ore inside the toolbox again, didn't you?
Maybe. Yep. I love that hum. It's like it's singing.
Like a siren song.
Yes. Like the siren song that leads the galaxy to a new way of thinking. A world where we stop killing one another. Where we use innovation and technology to help people and protect life, not casually destroy it as a matter of course. Like, don't you know?
I know. Like profit-focused warmongers with no moral compass beyond the almighty dollar.
Exactly.
A.K.A. Atlas's motto.
No cruelty. No killing. No compromise.
You're a revolutionary, boss.
Ooh, who are we rising up against?
Not that kind of revolutionary, Timmy. Don't worry.
I won't. Revolutions typically generate a 30% increase in market share. Good for business! In fact, the only thing better for business than revolutions are the vicious campaigns of suppression by the ruling elite that inexorably follow!
Timmy, that's reprehensible.
It is?
Yes.
I'm reprehensible?
No, you're not. I'm sorry. Just... that bit of programming is just a little heartless.
Oh, I see. I think I understand. Timmy will remember that.
Oh, crap. Did you break him?
I'm learning so much today!
Right. Anyway, are you here for something in particular, Timmy?
Yes, please. I'm here on behalf of Mr. Strongfork to inquire why our company's test subjects are somehow liberated.
I'm sorry. Test subjects?
The Javers.
Liberated.
Correct. Your comprehension level is impeccable. You should have no trouble explaining why the Javers are loose. Again. They're currently running amok down the laboratory hallways. The janitorial staff is prepping for what I like to call go jabber grabber time. What an interesting frequency. It vibrates at the speed of guilt.
But you have no proof.
The thing is, every use of credentials to access a security feature is logged. We have a record of your ID being used to open the cages.
Someone else could have grabbed it.
The other thing is, our security surveillance system filmed you doing it. If it's any consolation, the footage from this incident was captured at a much more flattering angle than the footage of you releasing the jabbers those other times.
I made it very clear that I will not condone experimenting on live animals on this ship.
It was in that memo she sent out.
It was a mission statement.
Well, now that we've got that straightened out... Ah, Dr. Dar, you have an update to your calendar incoming. It's an appointment with Mr. Strongfork.
Oh, I can check my schedule to see...
The appointment is now.
Oh, and, what is it regarding?
It's a reprimand session for Mr. Strongfork to reprimand you.
Oh.
Wait. Better not go empty-handed. Good luck.
Octavio.
Oh, Nestor! School's out already? Hey, Papa Girardi! I can smell your space calzones from here!
Ah, thanks! I need a new name for them!
Might also need to stop doing that problematic accent!
Yeah, I know.
Miss Johnson, did you get a cybernetic leg? That thing's straight fire. Jesse, how's it hanging, dude?
You know, Octavio, it's a brand new day. Filled with endless possibilities and excitement.
Sounds like it. New Agorex, who dis?
Another new device? Come on, Octavio. It's Radon. But listen, I'm almost done with this demolition job. Wanna head to Paco's for tacos?
Ooh, do they come in my favorite flavor?
Please don't say...
Free!
You're such a mooch. I'll see you there.
Octavia.
God, jeez!
I anticipated your arrival and have been waiting in a location that would not obstruct others.
Louis, what is wrong with you? Hiding in dark alleys like that?
I am not sensitive to disparities in luminosity. This seemed a perfectly acceptable place to stand. I acquired the publication you requested.
Come on.
Your biometrics read extreme disappointment.
It's Forge's super successful Dirty 30. It lists the planet's most promising, innovative entrepreneurs, and I'm not on it. Again!
Have you accomplished some extraordinary business transaction to warrant your acknowledgement on this list?
I survived Malawan's invasion. And I'd like to think that my social influence has kept the city together after the war left it in damn near ruins.
No would have been a more succinct answer.
Look, I'm working on it.
Why? This list is merely the opinion of other humans. You should not value it. As a machine, I find this accolade pointless to strive for.
Getting on Forge's super successful Dirty 30 is a lifelong dream. It's irrefutable proof to the rest of the world that Octavia Wallace Starr exists. That I'm a somebody.
I know you're somebody.
Yeah, but you're an assassination bot, which makes it weird.
Perhaps you are disappointed, but look on the bright side. Many of these celebrated humans have contracts on their heads. Bivington Bradwick, for example, has numerous bounties on his life, but no assassination bot can kill him. He is rich and important enough that he never has to leave his home or do anything for himself. You, however, are not on this list. You're anonymous, unrecognized, a nobody. This is beneficial for your survival.
But not beneficial for my image. I mean, all the best business people have probably at least killed someone to succeed. Something to warrant a bounty anyway. I'm doing whatever it takes to maintain appearances. Come on, if there was a list of all the best assassination bots, wouldn't you want to be on it?
No.
I pour my heart and soul, confide my lifelong ambition to be on this list, and you act all superior robot on me.
But I am a superior robot. I have killed 963 people. You have killed no one.
Don't diminish my potential. It's not that I couldn't kill. I could, if that's what it took.
Despite your erratic behavior today, I am in need of your assistance.
Sorry, I'm busy networking, innovating, shaking hands. After Malawan killed nearly half the merchants in the city, we've all needed to make new contacts.
This would be an actual job, with money. Your various business concepts lack financing, marketing, public appeal.
Kidding! I'm not busy. Totally pranked you. You just got Octavio.
Interesting phrasing. Perhaps I'll adopt that.
Well, that's kind of my thing, but...
Now, on to business matters. You will aid me, as you have before, in confirming the names of my targets before I shoot two ion slugs into their brain. You know how to talk. You have a mouth. You will prove exceptional.
Meet some new people, develop some street cred. This could be good for business.
That's the spirit. And let's not forget the aforementioned money.
Whatever it takes to get my business off the ground.
Do you actually have an idea for your business?
Tons! A few. I'm working on it.
Son of a skag-kissing rat's ass!
Congratulations, Francine Miskowitz. It has been 90 days since your last uncontrolled outburst of rage.
All right. Let's make it to 91. Get to work.
Take pride in your ability to maintain a positive attitude even though a Malawan space laser decimated your Froger chunk and subsequently reduced its Echo Net Yowl rating by 3.5 stars.
Thank you, SponsorBot.
Your Yowl rating is now negative 3.5 stars.
Thank you, SponsorBot. As soon as the insurance money comes in, this place will look good as new. Fella proves my claim to fix this place up, I'll have TDR paid back quicker than a chick reload.
Some guns reload very slowly.
Thanks for reaching out, SponsorBot. You're my rock.
It's a bad metaphor. If you're going to do metaphors, be better at them.
Oh, connection's gone squirrely. Can't hear you. Talk later. Everything's gonna be just fine.
My new slaughter-o-matic combat vegetable knife slices artichokes as easily as arteries.
We're not open yet. And, lore. How's business treating you, handsome?
Not bad. If there's two things you can count on Prometheans buying, it's bullets and brew. Place looks as charming as ever. I thought the insurance money was supposed to come through by now.
Claims guys coming by today, they've been jerking me around, saying I have to pass some sort of final interview to get my cash.
How dare they not trust a kind old lady like you? Want me to shoot them? It's been a while since I shot anyone. A week, at least. Still, I'm a steady trigger. So long as I've got some caffeine in me.
How could they deny my claim? Look at this place.
I'm sure you're right. All insurance workers are compassionate, honorable people.
Well, the claims fella gives me any lip, he'll find out how persuasive I can be.
What a disturbing euphemism.
Thanks for this, by the by.
Samesies. Uh-oh. Looks like the morning rush has arrived. I'm outie.
All right. Time to make the Frogurts. Good morning. Welcome to Franz Frogurts. What can I get you today, hon?
A large peanutty buddy with sprinkles.
Here you go, sweetheart.
Whoa! This looks incredible, Fran!
I know, babe.
There you go. Yes!
Welcome to Mr. Strongborg's office! Please make yourself comfortable while I inform him of your presence.
Just apologize for the jabbers. Won't happen again, sir. You cannot lose this job. My idea is a paradigm shift. One that could help Atlas beat the competition. Yeah, that sounds great. Convincing. Job-saving. Right?
Timmy, tell Dr. Dar I'll see her now.
Dr. Dar?
Unbelievable!
Hello, sir. Mr. Strongfork. Is everything all right? Because I can come back if...
No. Everything's fine. It's fine. I just got a bid again on an ultra-rare Zero Voltlanders figurine. Again. It's an investment, you know what? Forget it. Never mind. Just come on in. Have a seat. Thanks for coming up on such short notice, but I figured I ought to just set a meeting as quickly as possible so we could touch base on the issue of you keep releasing jabbers on the ship! Again! You've got to stop doing that. And also, we're in space. We're all contained animals up here, Dr. Dar. If you're trying to power move me, my friend, it ain't gonna work. I use the old silent treatment plenty of times in my day. Some might take your silence as intimidating, but we both know you just couldn't decide what to say.
I will, remember that.
And don't think your silence decreases your guilt either. It doesn't. You're very guilty, and I resent that your guilt forces me to be all boss-like and threaten to take your job away. It's clear you aren't thinking about my feelings when you release these jabbers. And what's more, you cost me a fortune! Do you have any idea? Any? I have guys in R&D working on cold fusion-powered giant robots who spend less money than you've wasted on freeing animals from their cages. And Iridium Ore. Oh my God! The Iridium Ore! If I'd seen any evidence at all, a shred of it, that you had been using that iridium ore to make something that, you know, we could sell, or patent, or eat. I wouldn't care, but... Now that is a pretty interesting little gun there, huh? Look at it all gun-shaped.
This is no gun, Mr. Strongfork. This is my... device.
Okay.
This device is... going to achieve something no one ever has. Something no one has come close to. Replicating the powers of a siren with the pull of a trigger!
Now that's a pitch! Keep going. I'm serious. This is exciting. The cold fusion robot guys, they give a fun presentation, but it's always, you know, a little much.
With power like this, we can save the world.
Which one?
All of them.
Now that's a lot of markets to have shares of. Okay, decent pitch. I give it a C-. Enough to not get you fired. Yet. So, I'm gonna need a demonstration to see what this adorable little game changer of yours can do.
Absolutely, sir. If you have space in your schedule in 2 weeks' time.
No, I meant now. There's no time like the present, right? So, present!
But I haven't... It hasn't... It's in progress, and...
It doesn't do anything, does it?
No, it does. Just let me explain.
Oh, by all means. And by all means, I mean this had better be really, really good, or you're fired.
It's an energy manipulator, designed to move any tangible subject through space-time.
Move through?
Transport, yes.
It's a phase walk gun?
It's a phase walk device. A phaser.
A phaser.
A totally non-lethal, utterly decisive way to end any conflict.
Wait. Non-lethal?
Yes.
So, to clarify, You have spent all the money and resources at your disposal that I gave you from my disposal to build a gun that does not kill people?
I've built a device.
Gun.
Device that doesn't kill. It just sends people on a little vacation.
A vacation to death?
No, just a vacation. They literally vacate.
Our customers don't want to send people on vacation. They want to send them to death! Okay. You know what? Show me. Show me, or put it on the desk, and leave my office!
Okay. I think you're really going to like this, sir.
I am waiting to be deeply, deeply impressed here. I mean, floored, really, at this... Oh, my God. Oh, my God!
Right?
That wasn't the blast dummy! It was on display! I can't... Oh, my God.
Oh.
Okay. Impressive. It's very impressive. Now, you know, reverse phase. Unzap. De-eliminate. Bring it back.
There's no reverse switch, sir. It only does the one thing, so far. It's a prototype.
Well, where the hell did it send my stuff?
I do not know.
So it's just... gone? Gone forever. Like so many fabric scraps in the wind. Coasting through the ether. I'll never see that tie again.
I could get you some electrical tape, sir.
It won't be the same.
Mr. Strongfork! CEO of the Atlas Company. I am your assistant.
Yeah, Timmy, I know.
Then now is my time to shine! Let me assist you.
Wait, Timmy, what?
I will go on a quest to retrieve what you have lost, rescue mission!
You would do that? For me?
Of course I would! Mr. Strongfork! CEO of the Atlas Company. Doing anything and everything for you is literally the purpose of my existence.
Yikes.
Yeah, well, that's a fair point, actually. All right. Dr. Dar, let's try this again. On Timmy.
I'm ready!
Timmy? Timmy? If he doesn't come back, you'll be hearing from me. Specifically, the sound of my tears.
He'll definitely come back. I think. Someday.
Can I just say, for a gun?
Device.
That's designed to be non-lethal? That thing is really doing some damage.
Thank you?
Not a compliment. You can't control it. You barely know what it does, except that it doesn't kill things, which makes it useless.
It isn't designed to kill. Not everything needs to harm people.
I feel harmed. I feel very personally harmed. Just not in a way that's profitable. Oh my God, why? Oh, Timmy, where are you when I need you most? You've reached Ree Strongfork, the CEO of Atlas Corporation.
Well, if it isn't Reese Strongfork.
Susan Coldwell, CEO of TDR. Why are you calling me? You know what? Can you hold on for just a sec? Dr. Dar, you may go. And if it wasn't clear already, you're fired.
But, sir...
Susan, how'd they hang in?
Perky as ever, Reese. And you? Eyes and limbs all accounted for?
Oh, yep. All good over here. Doing just great. Better than. Was there, something you needed?
You know the drill. I can't kill my targets until they say their full name out loud, and I am able to confirm its match against the name in the database. That's where you come in. So you must get my target to say their full name out loud.
Why do you always need my help with this?
People become uncomfortable around assassination bots and tend to refrain from divulging any information out of fear they might be a target. People are not afraid of you.
Thanks. Hey, I will be intimidating. You're looking at a future member of Forge's super successful Dirty 30.
My optics cannot corroborate that data.
What did they do, whoever you're about to kill?
A man named Jamison Harwin kicked his neighbor's pet scat pup. So the neighbor contracted me to punish him.
Well, I mean, did the skag do something to deserve getting kicked?
Blaming's a victim, Octavio. For shame. For shame.
It's not that. Maybe it was self-defense.
I said, for shame. Do you have any further questions before we begin the operation? It shouldn't take long.
Oh, ready to be your minion.
Very well. We will proceed then. Jamison Harwin lives in that apartment complex. You will use the buzzer for apartment 3 to get him to come outside. I will be waiting nearby, with death.
All right. I guess he deserves it. Let's go. Pizza here for apartment 3?
What? I didn't order any pizza.
No offense, but are you by any chance drunk, sir?
Well, yeah. How the hell's that relevant?
Drunk folk order pizza, then forget about it. Happens all the time. Think of me as a present from your past self.
All right. I'll be down. Just give me a sec.
Well, I must admit, your methods are strange. It seems to have worked. Now you must get him to say his full name before I can fulfill the contract.
No problem.
Give it here, kid. What gives? I come all the way down here and you don't even got it? You better not be messing with me, boy. I got a hell of a temper.
Sir, I'm so sorry. Someone just ran by and stole it right out of my hands. Can I confirm your full name so I can make sure you get a replacement?
I was really looking forward to that unexpected pizza, and now I really want it. My name's Jamison Harwin, and I want to talk to your manager.
You just got L0U13. Did I do it right?
Nailed it. Jamison Harwin, we hardly knew you, but you did seem like a real bastard.
Well done. I have received payment. Here is your commission, friend Octavio.
Ooh, cash money! Make it rain! I'm meeting the crew at Paco's. You in?
I am indeed in. Though I still cannot fathom how you can eat food from a man who lives in the sewers and befriends Ratch.
I use a lot of hot sauce? And that's how Papa Girardi makes a space calzone.
Fascinating. I have an additional inquiry. You mentioned your past proclivity for stealing. As you know, many of my contracts have been for idiot petty thieves, such as yourself. Now, your sister.
Anu.
Your sister Anu disapproves of this proclivity and wishes for you to stop stealing. Are you heeding her counsel? It is a dangerous hobby, Larceny.
I'm stealing to survive. Anu knows how hard it is to live in a war zone. She left me here to fend for myself. But of course, why should that stop her from judging me?
It sounds like you're judging her.
Can it, robot?
Oh, Octavio! Hi.
Louis? Let me introduce you to Diamond Danielle, a real thief and definitely not an idiot.
That's one way to introduce a friend. Sure.
Greetings. Diamond Danielle must be a moniker. Since it obscures your real name, I have a 0% probability of killing you.
Are you flirting with me, robot?
No.
Real charmer.
He's working on his people skills.
I am not.
We're on our way to Paco's to meet up with Radon. Wanna come?
Tacos? I'm there.
You are not. We must ambulate there.
Ignore him.
How many times do I have to tell you to sweep behind the counter, Octavio? Killing me. Help you out in a sec.
You want to help me? You'll give me what I asked for, and you know damn well what that is.
Henry?
Hank!
What brings you around these parts?
Same as always. You owe me for protection, and my price ain't budging.
You know, usually a protection shakedown involves actually protecting a place. Didn't see you anywhere when Malawan was blasting holes in my store.
Don't blame me for the whims of our corporate overlords. There's only one thing I want. And it's time to pay up.
I'm sorry, but there's no way I can give you a lifetime of free Frogurt, Hank. Not at the rate you eat it.
Why? Huh? Do it! Hey, do it, or I'm gonna kill you!
That's how it's gonna be?
I tried to be patient. But you feed me enough frozen yogurt to keep me on a 24/7 sugar high, or I feed you the tip of this pick! I'm through asking. You're gonna give me what I want, or we're gonna have a dozen flavors worth of problem. What? That was it! That was the threat! Now, maybe... maybe I just kill you and take this place over for myself. Yeah. Yeah, that'd be pretty cool. And frankly, what'd be the difference? Huh? Whether it be an ice pick to the eye or slowly wasting away in debt to the Tedior Corporation, you are dead. Either way. Face it, Fran. You failed. Maybe you could have been somebody once upon a time, but that was a good 10,000 Frogurts and a Malawan laser ago. You have got nothing! No. I'm sorry, that was too generous. You are nothing.
Here goes nothing. Get the hell out of my shot!
Oh, she's angry. It's been years since I fought a geriatric. Come on!
Thank you.
Any last words?
Order up.
Jeez! Oh no! Is that blood? Am I bleeding?
I tried to be nice, but this time you've gone too far. Thanks for coming by.
You are off the wagon. It is now 15 seconds since your last rage-filled outburst. Let's prevent further tirades. Here's a calming exercise. List the nutritional facts of Peanutty Buddy.
Total calories per half cup, 400, 25 grams of fat, 41 grams of carbohydrates, 38 grams of sugar, 4 grams of protein.
Congratulations, you are now calm.
Fudging hell. Be right with you, dear.
What am I gonna do now? Where am I gonna go? I mean, we're in space. I live here. What's Octavio gonna say? The way we left things. I know this can work. I just need more time and someone with enough vision to see its potential.
Oh, hey, Anu. No big deal or anything, but can you come back to the lab real quick? Like, really, really quick, like, before you get killed?
Killed? That's a little dramatic, Fong. I got fired. It's a setback, sure, but not a death sentence.
What? You got fired? Yikes and a half. That sucks. Wait, does that mean I'm fired too? You know what? Forget it. Not even on my list of things to stress about right now. We are in the middle of a TDR invasion with dudes in body armor and guns of an admittedly lower quality than Atlas's. The whole shebang. So, let's go.
An invasion by a rival weapons manufacturer.
And I'm fired. And it's not even lunch.
On the upside, the vet sent an echo. Your pet fish is doing great.
Oh.
Wait. I misread. It's, dead. Sorry.
It's okay. The words look similar.
Yeah, so remember when Malawan tried to stage a hostile force takeover of Atlas back on Promethea?
Of course, I'm from Promethea.
It was devastating for Atlas, and they blew up Strongfork's favorite Frogurt place or something.
No, yeah, actually, my brother works there.
Well, I guess TDR smelt blood in the water and decided it's their turn to take a stab at Atlas because they are a hundo P boarding this facility right now and it is hostile. Like, very, very hostile.
How do you know all this?
Oh.
Employees of Atlas, let's all give our surprise guests from TDR a warm welcome and show them what makes Atlas the company it is. And by warm welcome, I of course mean show them everything we've been working on lately at close range.
Let's be elsewhere, fast!
He felt weird.
Oh, crap! Hide, hide, hide!
If you were keeping an active vault key somewhere on your space station, where would you hide it? Boss lady said it's in his office, so that's where we're going. I just don't underestimate this guy, all right? Affirmative. I heard he ripped his own eyeball out. It's kind of crazy you don't mess with.
Gentlemen, lovely to see ya. I'd offer you a beverage, but my assistant Timmy was recently teleported to God knows where.
Reese Strongfort. We are here for the vault key and or your bloodied corpse.
Hey, fellas, come on. Come in. Have a seat. Say, would either of you be interested in a career change? We've got some killer benefits.
Could I get a cocktail?
Fired during a hostile takeover? Yeesh! Bet you can kiss your severance package goodbye.
Oh no. I've got it right here. That door wasn't broken the last time I came through it.
That's the thing about hostile takeovers. They're hostile.
You smell like guilt and shame. Did your mommy bring a packed lunch? Resistance is...